Well. Pretty clear how all this happened.
Practically printed on this poor stiff's face.
Look at the writing in blood that meets the victim's fingertip. Very apparent that her death was instantaneous, giving our killer time to write this message, which appears to be his own name.
I'm gonna have to question your autopsy work there. Look at the bruising on our Vic's arm. It's obvious that she was a dedicated martial artist, and she was not going down without a fight.
Close, but no cigar. If you look at the entry wound, the bullet into the hip, it's apparent that our victim was...
Our victim?
3½. Yeah. You know, the killer.
Yeah, our victim, the killer.
Didn't you get the dictionary?
Oh, right, sorry.
Our killer was 3½ feet tall. If our victim was a dedicated martial artist, that micro man wouldn't have stood a chance.
Not quite, though, mon frere. Look at how the alarm is torn off the doorway. Someone 3½ feet tall wouldn't have been able to reach that, which means their killer was an able-bodied man crawling on all fours.
So set a slow yet again, my good friend. Look at this hand print right by the victim's hand. The one that looks like the victim's hand, is shaped like the victim's hand, and has the exact same dimensions of the victim's hand.
Well, look at that. It even has her fingerprints, too.
Yes. So we can conclude that this handprint belongs to the killer. Now, let me ask you, the killer of a handprint in this direction while performing the murder, what does that tell you?
My God!
That's right. He was crab-walking when performing the dastardly deed.
But that would mean...
His bloody hand all over this tiled floor.
The floor's floor wax would be ruined.
And that means...
Chief!
This isn't just a case of murder, but property damage. And now, I bring shocking news to the autopsy squad. Flip this case upside down. The person lying in front of you is dead.
No!